if you're going to tame your thoughts, if you're going to tame your memory, you've got to learn how to move out of negative thinking into a positive. And I need you to understand, this year going into 2011, you've got to learn how to tame yourself. Yeah. Oh, beloved, nobody can help you with your inner man. I can preach to you all day long, but I can't change your inner man. I can't help you tame the heart and the desire. I can only point out to you what thus said the Lord. But you need to understand, the man who writes this tells us that he could not tame himself. He tells us in Romans chapter 7 that the things I ought to do, I find myself not doing. And the things that I know I should not do, I find myself doing. Why? Paul, because inside of me there is a war. And there is a carnal law and a spiritual law. And sometimes if it's a war, everybody got to win. You understand? In a war, one side can't win all the time. That wouldn't be a war. That would be a massacre. But what he said, there is a war. And so that means this carnal got to win sometime. And the spiritual got to win sometime. And then he said, and because of that, how can I rise from this state? Well, he says, thanks be unto God for Jesus Christ. Because the only way that I can really tame this flesh is I've got to put it in the hands of Jesus Christ. And so, beloved, how can I forget? I've got to learn that the only way I can really forget is not only in God's time, but it's also in me working with God for personal taming. But the best way for me to tame myself is to alter my thinking. In verse 16, Paul says, ye who are mature, think this way. In other words, you who have come up and have grown on the journey, or to help somebody regroup their thoughts. Do you know one of the top selling books of all time, next to the Bible, is something written in 1954 by Norman Vincent Van Peel, which is entitled The Art of Positive Thinking. It continues to grow, it continues to sell, because he tried to let somebody know that the only way you're going to make it on this journey is to forget the negative and focus your mind on the positive. And so Paul looked at it and he wrestled with, how can I forget the things which are behind? How can I reach forward to those things which are ahead? He says and answers his own question in verses 7 and 8 of chapter 4. He says, first off, I've got to alter my thinking. I've got to have something that brings peace to my troubled mind. Some of us are troubled in thought because we think too much. Some of us cannot sleep at night because we think too much. Some of us are struggling with trial and tribulation because we think too much. And so what Paul says is, I've got to regroup and alter my thoughts. I can't be thinking about what I've done in the past or what I've achieved in the past. You can't change the past, but you can build on the past. And so Paul says, I can't go through life with guilt and shame. I can't go through life with past accolades of fame. What I've got to do is get deal with my present. And how do I do that? Well, he says, there is a peace of God which surpasses all understanding. And that peace can keep your heart and your mind through Christ Jesus. And so the only way that I can really forget, I've got to put my mind on Jesus. I've got to try to figure out, I can't make peace with myself. And if I can't make it with myself, truly, I can't make it with you. And so if I'm going to make it, I've got to learn how to get the peace of God that will surpass all understanding. I've got to get at peace with myself, with my present, and with my issues. And the only way that I can really keep my heart in my mind is in verse 8, finally, brother, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, praise speak on these things. Those things that will change your mind. On a personal note, I have to remember that my present position is positioning me for my future. And where I am right now will determine where I will be on tomorrow. Because if I don't get it right with God, in hell, I will lift up my eyes. And so God is not going to determine where to put me on judgment day. Living my life I am right now will determine what I will do. And let me help you with something. At the end of this month, when your mortgage and your rent is due, the decision you make today, should you buy that new coat, buy that new car, buy that new ring, will determine if you put out at the end of the month. Because the decision you make today will radically impact you tomorrow. So where are you headed, Rev? Well, I'm trying to help somebody by letting you know you're not going to sleep at night tomorrow. Because your mind is messed up today. You're not going to have tomorrow, because the thoughts you have are not good today. But if you want to bring peace to your soul, if you want to be able to forget those things which are behind and begin to work your way towards that of your future, you got to look at Paul and get your mind off your past and put your mind on your future and allow God to know that I'm going to move from the negative to the positive. I'm going to move from the pain to the passion. And recognize the grief is going to change the glory. Because I read what 1 Peter said, that after I suffer a while, that God's going to make me perfect. He's going to establish and strengthen me. And so I've come to let you know that you got to suffer a while. You got to go through some things, but don't put your mind on your storm. Don't put your mind on your rain. Put your mind on the wealthy place that God has in store. I understand that I'm catching a little hell right now, but I've come to tell you that hell is not on my mind. Is on the other side of Jordan. My mind is not on the hell right here, but on the heaven up there. And I hear somebody singing in song, heaven is my goal each and every day. I've got to keep on moving in a narrow way. And if I stumble while I'm on the way, step aside, cause I want nobody stumbling over me. And so I've come to let you know you can put your mind on what you're going through, or you can put your mind on where you're headed to. If you're in the wilderness, there's a land with milk and honey. If you're in a desert place, there's a valley that's further on the other side. If you're down in the valley, who knows that a valley is between two mountains. And so if I'm going through the valley, I'm on my way to a mountain. And I don't want to look at the valley. I want to keep my mind on the mountain. So how can I forget? I've got to look to the hills from which cometh my help. And all of my help comes from the Lord. So there is one thing that I shall not forget. I can forget about pain. I can forget about failure. I can forget about success. I can forget where I was born. I can forget where I came out. But there is one thing I dare not forget. That it was early one Friday morning on a hill called Calvary. I can forget what you did to me, but I cannot forget what we did to him. I can't forget how I was mistreated, but I shall not forget what happened on Calvary. I because if I'm going to make it, I got to remember he was wounded for my transgression. He was bruised for my iniquity. And the chastisement of my peace was laid on him. And